to subscribe!
Hello?
Hi, Bororo! It's Tayo!
Hi, Tayo! What's up?
I had so much fun today! I wanted to tell you about it!
Wow, really? What did you do today?
Rogi and I found an old parking lot today, and we got in trouble with Hana and Sito because we got dirty while playing! My friends and I always felt sad because we couldn't run freely in the garage, and there's no space anywhere to run to our heart's content. But today, there's a playground!
Wow! There's a playground?
Yep! Robbie cleaned the parking lot really well and made it into a playground!
Robbie? You mean Robbie the street sweeper?
That's right! But after playing like crazy, I realized everyone just runs fast and there's no order.
Really? Oh, gosh.
Eventually, there was an accident and everyone got hurt. So Hana said we should pick a playground president.
Playground president? Tayo, are you running for it?
Oh, no. I'm not running. Lonnie, Tony, Speed, and Ruby were the candidates.
Ruby... Ruby who made the playground?
Yep. Ruby always does what he has to do quietly, like cleaning the parking lot. Other friends wanted to be president too, but I picked Ruby. In the end, Ruby became the president.
Playground president? Way to go, Ruby! Should we pick a playground president too?
Oh, yeah! Your town also had a nice playground. What do you do on the playground?
Yes, our town also has an awesome playground. We play hide and seek on the playground, and we also play on the swings. I love hide and seek!
Me too!
I played hide and seek today too. Petty caught me and I became it. Petty's so good at finding things. Today Krong?
What? What about Krong?
We were all playing hide and seek and heard a strange sound. It was Krong sleeping on top of the slide. He was slowly sliding down the slide.
What to do with him?
Right? What can we do? But when I showed Krong disapproval, Loopy suddenly started talking about what happened in the past.
What happened?
When I was it before, I suddenly got a stomach ache while looking for my friends. So I ran to the bathroom with all my might.
And then?
Well, I ran to the bathroom and did my business. And afterward, I got hungry.
What? Huh?
So I snuck food out of the refrigerator and ate. And I got caught.
What to do with you? It's been so much fun. Okay, I have to go now. Let's talk again tomorrow.
Okay, see you tomorrow. Bye.
Okay, bye.
Hello?
Bororo, I can't take it. I'm so hungry.
What? You haven't eaten yet?
There was a huge ordeal today, too.
what ordeal?
Well, Hana prepared some engine oil for me and my friends today. Rogi secretly ate everybody's oil all by himself.
All of it by himself? Tile, how did you find out that Rogi ate it secretly?
Rogi has been hiccuping all day.
Hiccups?
Yes, hiccups. Rogi snuck and ate the engine oil, went to work and suddenly started hiccuping and made the passengers uncomfortable. The hiccups continued to the point where he couldn't work anymore. I saw the passengers getting off at the bus stop.
I see. But how did you know that Rogi ate it secretly from his hiccups?
Met told me.
Met?
Yes. Mr. Jack-of-all-trades Subway Met. I was really worried that Rogi's hiccups didn't stop. But Nuri told me to ask Met, who knows everything, how to stop them. So Rogi and I went to ask Met. Met said that if you secretly eat, you get hiccups. Then he startled Rogi all of a sudden and stopped his hiccups.
Wow! Met really knows everything! Wait a minute. If you get hiccups because you secretly eat something... Krong!
What's wrong, Pororo?
Krong's hiccups didn't stop the other day either. My friends and I eventually startled Krong and stopped it, but... I never thought Krong's hiccups came from eating something secretly. Aha! That's the reason why all of the snacks disappeared that morning!
We should definitely share yummy food!
Yep! Come to think of it, the sandwich Loopy gave me yesterday was really good!
Oh, Loopy! You said Loopy is a great cook, right?
Yes, Loopy is a great cook! The food Loopy makes is really, really delicious! But yesterday, my friends and I kept asking Loopy to make more sandwiches because they were so delicious. So she had a hard time.
Oh, I see.
We didn't think about Loopy being very tired from cooking all day. As soon as Petty brought up how hard it must have been for Loopy, I remembered her weary look yesterday. But Eddie came up with a good idea.
What idea?
For today, we decided to make food for Loopy!
Wow! Loopy must have loved it!
I hoped so, and I worked hard to prepare. Krong and I baked bread for Loopy, and meaning to just take a little taste of it, we ate the whole thing.
What?
Polby and Harry caught only small fish, so the amount was too small. And the Loopy-faced cake Eddie made looked nothing like Loopy. Petty fell asleep while baking the cookies and burned them all.
Oh no, Loopy must have been really upset.
I thought so too and felt really sorry. Loopy saw Aura miss our food, but still said thank you.
Loopy is so sweet.
Yep.
Oh, talking about food made me hungry. I'm going to go charge up.
Me too. Enjoy your meal, Tayo. Bye.
Okay, you too. Pororo, bye. Hello?
Hi, Tayo.
Oh, hey, Pororo, what's wrong? Why do you look so tired?
Yeah, it's because of cleaning.
Cleaning?
Yes. Krong suddenly became Mr. Clean today.
Mr. Clean?
Krong scribbled all over the place today and made a mess. And I nagged him a bit to clean up.
but he seemed to be having a hard time, so I cleaned with him.
Wow, that's good! Are you that tired from cleaning so hard?
No, cleaning wasn't that hard. The problem is that our friends who came to our house complimented Krong for cleaning well. And he just kept on cleaning.
He kept cleaning?
Oh,
well, isn't that good?
My friends and I thought the same, so we complimented Krong. It was great seeing him clean so well. I even nicknamed him Mr. Clean.
Ah, that's what you meant by Krong suddenly becoming Mr. Clean.
Yes, Krong cleaned really hard. But he put away books I took out to read, and he wouldn't let me stack blocks because it was going to make a mess.
What?
And if I dropped crumbs while eating, he got really angry. Then Krong got tired and struggled after organizing the book so well.
Krong really became a cleaning fairy.
Exactly.
But you must be relaxed since Krong is cleaning everything.
I'm not. Do you know what happened when I woke up today?
What happened?
Krong became Mr. Scribble again after being Mr. Clean.
What?
So it was hard to clean it up again.
How fun! Actually, Rogi cleaned a lot today too.
Rogi? Did Rogi mess up the house a lot too?
No. What happened today was... Robbie's cleaning equipment broke down today. So we needed to replace the equipment. I heard it would take 2 days for the equipment to be delivered. Also, the old equipment was too big for Robbie.
What? What now? Oh, that's why Rogi cleaned instead.
That's right. The old equipment fit Rogi perfectly, so Rogi cleaned instead.
Rogi became Mr. Clean too.
But Rogi wasn't enough to become Mr. Clean. He seemed to be doing a good job cleaning, but he made some mistakes. The customers got a little angry, and the other cars were a little irritated too.
Oh no! I hope Rubby's equipment arrives soon.
Yes, but Rubby was worried too. He was going to rest for the first time in a while until the cleaning equipment came, but whenever he saw trash, he kept trying to clean it up.
Rubby can't help it either.
Rubby must really like cleaning. But cleaning without the equipment, Rubby kept making mistakes. It was a bit of a hard day in many ways.
I suppose so. Rogi and Rubby must have had a hard time.
Yes, but thankfully, Rogi and Rubby understood each other and became closer.
Thank goodness!
Yeah!
Still, I hate cleaning.
Yep! But I'm still going to clean up my stuff.
True, true. Okay, I'm going to go clean up Krong's mess.
Yeah, me too. Enjoy cleaning, Pororo.
Okay, you too. Bye.
Bye. Hello? Pororo? Pororo, did you see the picture? Our town got our first snow yesterday.
First snow?
Yes! Yesterday was the first snow of the year. It was so pretty!
Snow fell for the first time? All right! It doesn't snow often in your town.
Oh, that's right! Your town is always covered with snow. Oh, you're lucky.
So, how was it? Did you have a snowball fight and go sledding?
Oh, actually, I've never seen snow. But a friend told me about it not long ago, so I learned about snow for the first time. And it snowed a lot yesterday! Oh, it was so pretty! Running in the snow felt good, too! I had to work in the afternoon yesterday, so I played in the snow in the morning and went right after. But I was afraid of being late, so I ignored Hannah's advice to come to the garage before work.
What?
I thought it would be okay, but snowy roads are much more slippery, making it hard to speed and stop properly. Oh.
But it's really fun to go boarding in slippery places like that.
I was working, though. Oh, but that's not all. It was hard to start because the tires were spinning out. Oh, and even the engine turned off suddenly.
Oh, that must have been a little scary.
Fortunately, I met up with C2 and came back to the garage safely. But, oh yeah, I was so scared yesterday. I thought it would only be fun if it snowed, but I was disappointed because it was full of obstacles. But you know, when I woke up today, Hannah called us outside. I was wondering what was going on, and there was a snowman!
A snowman?
Yes! Hannah was worried that I was too disappointed, so made it possible to play safely in the snow. I had a lot of fun in the snow with my friends today!
Wow, that must have been fun!
Yes, it was so much fun! Bororo, how was the weather in your town today? Did it snow?
It did snow, but it really, really snowed a lot in our town.
Whoa, that must have been great!
No, it was so much that we couldn't play outside.
What? Really? It can snow that much?
Yes, it's common in our town.
Oh, no. Then you must have been really bored.
No, I have fun at home on days like today. Loopy and Petty played ping pong at Loopy's house. Poby and Harry wrote a new song and sang it. And Rhodey and Eddie built blocks and played dominoes.
Wow! Everyone has fun at home, too! Then, Bororo, what did you do at home with Krong?
Us?
Yes, I'm sure you and Krong had a lot of fun, too, right?
Actually, I had a little argument with Krong.
What?
But Krong scribbled all over my book! And he wasn't even sorry. So I took my toy car and knocked down the blocks that Krong was playing with.
What? Oh, isn't that overdoing it?
But it's so obnoxious. Krong was so angry that he drew a line on the floor and told me not to cross it.
What? So immature. So you argue with Krong all day?
Yeah. But suddenly, the wind blew the window open, so we closed it together. And while looking at an album together that had fallen, we talked about the old days, and I apologized first.
Oh, so you made up with Krong! Thank goodness! Then, is it still snowing a lot in your town?
Yes, it's still very windy.
Oh, what happened? Did you drop your phone in the wind?
Hurry!
I'll just hang up today.
Hello?
Hi,
field day is when you gather with all your friends and compete in events.
Events with friends? Then, is it a field day when I play soccer with my friends?
It's a little bigger than that. Soccer ends after one game. A field day is a festival where teams play games like tire exchange, hurdling, tug of war, balloon pop, and relay races to score points.
Wow! That must have been so much fun! Tell me more about field day.
Okay! Before field day, the teams were divided into blue and white, and I was on the white team. But all the guys who are good at sports like Toto, who's strong, and Speed, who's fast, were on the blue team. So I did special training with my teammates.
Special training?
Yes. Up to the day before field day, we gathered and practiced every day. There were times when it was hard and times we weren't confident. But we practiced to the best of our ability.
Then I bet that you totally beat the blue team today.
I was a little nervous, too, but I thought I could win all the games if I just did as I had practiced. Oh, but I lost my first event in the tire volleyball game.
Even though you trained so hard?
Yeah. The second event was hurdling, and Speed was really fast. I ended up losing the second one, too.
Well, you lost again? The special training didn't help at all.
But all the good ones were on the blue team. The third event was tug of war. The blue team had Toto, who's strong, so I thought we were going to lose again. But something incredible happened!
What happened?
Toto burst into laughter and lost his balance! So our team was able to win for the first time!
The strong Toto made a mistake?
Right! After we won the third match, we found confidence and won the balloon pop and the relay race! My great performance stood out!
What? Your great performance? What to do with you? It must have been great to win on field day.
It was! But we learned that it's more important to have fun as a team than to win or lose.
Wow, that's awesome, Tayo!
Bororo! You exercise a lot, right? What kinds of things do you play with your friends?
We swim or play soccer, and sometimes we play badminton. We've skated before, too.
Wow, you do a bunch of things.
Yep, but out of everything, we go sledding the most. Because our town is always covered in snow.
Wow, sledding! That sounds like so much fun! I've never gone sledding before. Does it feel like going down a slide?
It's similar, but a much bigger slide. You go from the top of the mountain and zoom down to the bottom. Let's go sledding together when you come visit our town sometime, Tayo.
Sounds good! But I'm a boss. Can I ride a sled?
Sure you can. Dudu once went sledding with us, too.
Oh, Dudu? How?
The first day that Dudu came to our village, we were having a sled race. Dudu saw us from the top of the mountain. Maybe it seemed fun watching us, because Dudu jumped from the top of the mountain and started racing excitedly toward the finish line.
Wow! That sounds way more fun than a slide! Let's for sure go sledding next time!
Of course!
Oh, I'm looking forward to it! I think this would be a fun race!
Definitely! Then should we also have a race?
Now? Suddenly? What race?
How about who hangs up the phone fastest?
What?
It's no laughing matter. The smell is no joke.
But it's funny. I like farts.
What? You like farts?
Yep. I've been farting all day. I'm the best at farting among my friends. Even Rogi is not as good as I am. I can play a song with farts. Nobody can do that.
What?
For real! I made so many mistakes on my first day of work, and thanks to farting, I was able to successfully finish my first day.
Huh? Thanks to farting?
Yeah. I kept making mistakes and was so nervous when I got to the bus stop. A kid burst into tears saying that I was scary. His mom comforted him, but he refused and I was really embarrassed.
Oh no! Gosh! So then, Tayo, don't tell me!
Yeah. I was thinking about how to show that I'm not scary, so I farted vigorously! Fart, fart, fart! I farted so excitedly that he stopped crying and laughed. So I was able to successfully go with a child on board!
What to do with you? So you are the best at farting?
Yeah! But I've seen Max fart as well as I do before.
Max? The brave dump truck Max?
Yep. We had a quiz game once, and one of the tasks was to copy the sound of my farts. Everyone else didn't do well, but Max did a great job.
Seriously?
That's why I'm telling you not to give Krong a hard time.
But Krong's farts smell horrible. Krong always eats meat and doesn't want any vegetables. Even when Loopy makes delicious salads, he never eats it. He's so greedy, he even steals my meat.
Oh, goodness. He should eat a balanced diet.
Exactly. That's why Krong's constipated, because he never eats vegetables, and why his farts smell so terrible. Petty was going to go wash her hands in the bathroom after Krong, but ran away without washing her hands because of the awful smell. That's how bad it is.
Oh, it's that bad?
Yes. Harry almost fainted. When Krong farted right next to us, we all ran out of the house.
Oh, I see. Is Krong not that healthy then?
He's fine now. Ever since he started eating vegetables well, he's been pooping well, and his fart smell isn't as bad as it used to be.
You have to eat a balanced diet for sure.
That's right. This is a secret, but...
What? What is it?
Back then, Krong, when he pooped, his poop was so big that... Krong sent a message. It startled me.
Me too.
I guess he's listening somewhere. I'm scared, so I'm out of here.
Yeah, okay. I'll hang up now.
Okay, bye!
Bye!
Hello?
Hello? Bororo? Why are you talking so slowly?
I'm going to do everything slowly.
Why all of a sudden?
Today, Poppy and Harry.
Oh, so frustrating. Talk more quickly.
Sorry. There was a huge incident with Poppy and Harry today.
What incident?
Well, you can see the sunset in the evening when you look out at the sea from the top of the iceberg. So my friends and I decided to go up the iceberg. We waited a long time for Poby and Harry, but they didn't come. So we went up first because we didn't want to miss the sunset. The sunset I saw from the top of the iceberg was really amazing. The blue sky turning red was so...
Oh, Bororo! So what happened to Poby and Harry?
All right. It's so cool even when I think about it again. Poby is usually so slow that Harry often nags him. Harry missed the sunset today because he was again waiting for the slow-moving Poby. So Harry was very upset.
Oh, my!
But after the sunset, there was a shooting star in the night sky. It was like a shooting star show with so many shooting stars at the same time. I heard it's really rare to see.
Wow! That must have been really cool! I want to see it too! Do you have a picture?
I do! One second!
Wow! It's so pretty! Oh, to see this in person! Poby and Harry are so lucky!
Yes! I wish I had seen it too! I'm really jealous of Poby and Harry, so I decided to be slow starting today.
Oh! That's why you spoke so slowly earlier!
Well, I learned today that sometimes it's better to slow down than to be in a hurry.
Right! That's something Speed and Shine need to learn.
Why Speed and Shine?
Well, not long ago, I ran into Shine and Speed while taking a walk. But they were arguing about who was faster. And then, the two of them suddenly started racing!
What? Where? At the stadium?
No, in the middle of the road!
What? Isn't that really dangerous?
Oh, it's really dangerous! Fortunately, thanks to Pat and Rookie following and telling Speed and Shine not to do that, there was no big accident.
Phew, thank goodness.
But the race between Speed and Shine was not over. After a long tit-for-tat, they decided to race a high-speed train.
With a high-speed train?
Yes. They said a high-speed train is the fastest thing on wheels. So if you beat a high-speed train, you'll be the fastest car in the world!
Okay, but it's too dangerous.
That's why I was so worried, too!
So did Speed and Shine beat a high-speed train?
Speed raced so hard that he couldn't catch his breath, but still couldn't keep up with the train. Shine also started off confidently and seemed to catch up with the train, but fell behind again.
So no one could beat the high-speed train after all.
Shine caught up with the high-speed train again at a tremendous speed.
What? So Shine is the fastest car in the world?
Shine was so fast then that you would have thought so. But suddenly, there was a popping sound. And Shine was floundering!
Why?
Shine didn't want to lose the race, so he secretly modified his engine on the way over. That's why the engine broke down! Luckily, there wasn't a bigger accident thanks to Rookie, Pat, and Toto's help. And Speed and Shine were banned from operating for a while.
What a close call! It'd be better if Speed and Shine were slow like Poby.
Yes, don't be in a hurry. Slow down.
Just now, what passed by?
Oh, is it Shine?
Out of my way!
I think you're going to have to go and tell them to slow down.
I should, right? Okay, see you tomorrow, Bororo!
Okay, bye!
Thank you.
Hello?
Bororo! You did a play too?
Yes, we did the Three Little Pigs.
That's wonderful! How was the play?
It was a success. I went to Eddie's house not long ago, and he was doing a play on the book he was reading. That's when I first learned that a play meant acting out roles to tell a story on a stage. Krong was watching from the side, and he wanted to do a play too. So he brought over the Three Little Pigs book.
So Krong was the first to want to do it.
Yep. So we decided to do a play and chose our roles. Petey, Loopy, and I were the Three Little Pigs. And the wolf was Krong. Harry was the narrator, and Eddie and Poby designed the stage.
Oh, it sounds fun!
We rehearsed the play diligently and finally went on stage today.
You must have done as well as you practiced.
Well, we had a good start. I worked hard to build a strong house so that the wolf couldn't come, and the first and second pigs fooled around and roughly built houses with straw and wood.
Yes, I know the story. And the wolf blows the first straw house down like, whoo!
That's how it should go. But Eddie, who was holding the wind prop, fell on the stage. And then when it was time to blow down the second wood house, Poby dozed off. So the house crumbled before Krong even blew on it.
Oh no! So the play was basically ruined?
But Rhodey saved the day by improvising his lines and saying, "How roughly was this house built that it would fly away before the wind blew?"
Rhodey is awesome!
Yep, Rhodey saved the day.
The youngest pig's sturdy house doesn't fly away from the wolf's blow, so no chance for mistakes.
Since my house wouldn't blow away like you said, the wolf got angry. He tried to go down the chimney, got caught in my trap, and I defeated him fabulously. It was pretty perfect up to this point, but...
Now what?
Loopy and Petey must have been heartbroken seeing Rhodey and Krong pretending to be in pain on the floor. Suddenly, Loopy and Petey ran to the wolves and showed concern for them and even agreed to be friends.
What? That's not the original story.
Right. So we were all very embarrassed. But the friends who were watching said it was more fun than the Three Little Pigs book.
That's right! It was fun!
Thanks! How was your play today, Tayo?
We did a talent show play at the Namsan Festival! Hana told me about the boy who cried wolf, so I decided to do a play about it! Actually, we also did it a bit different from the original.
Huh? Why? Did you make mistakes too?
No! Lonnie and Gani were a little scared of the original story.
Ah, I see.
The shepherd boy was Rogi, and I was the wolf. Lonnie and Gani were the sheep, and the villagers were Hard and Peanut.
Everyone seems to fit their roles well.
Yes! We practiced really hard, too. We were a little nervous when we were on stage. But when Rogi, the shepherd boy, slyly lied that a wolf appeared, we all relaxed.
It's a story about the village people that were angry at the shepherd boy because he lied every day about the wolf showing up. Then when a wolf really did appear, the people thought the boy was lying again and didn't come to help.
That's how the story usually goes. We changed the story to the wolf showing up and the village people saving the shepherd boy who was in danger. Because you have to believe your friends no matter what. And the shepherd boy promised never to lie again.
Wow! This story is fun too.
Right?
We're also friends who believe each other no matter what.
Of course!
Okay, call me again tomorrow, Tayo.
Okay, talk later. Bye.
Bye.
Hello?
Looks like Frank and Alice, right?
Tayo, why are you laughing? Is there a secret in the picture?
Actually, it's not Frank and Alice. It's Connie and Tony! A carbon copy, right?
What? I was fooled! But why the disguise?
Oh, you know, Frank and Alice had a fight because of me.
Frank and Alice? Why?
Alice was getting maintenance done by Hana this morning. But my engine had broken down. I had to go pick up passengers, so I begged Hana to fix it quickly. When Alice saw that, she told me I could go first.
Alice is so nice. And then?
As I was working that day, I saw Frank and Alice from far away fighting at the scene of a fire. I heard that Alice let me get repair before her this morning, so I think she was late to the scene. Oh,
Tayo, you should have waited your turn and not begged to go first. Is that why you're trying to get Frank and Alice to make up?
Yes. Frank and Alice didn't seem to want to apologize first. That's why Rogi and I made a plan. We put a siren on Tony to make him look like Alice and put a ladder on Gani to make him look like Frank. So we had Gani acting like Frank to apologize to Alice and Tony acting like Alice to apologize to Frank. They both fell for it!
That's amazing, Tayo! Do you happen to have any close-up photos of the one you sent earlier? I want to see in detail how you disguise them.
Really? I'll send one now! Wait a minute!
Wow! That's how you did it? Tayo, what a good idea!
It was very successful! I did get in a bit of trouble when Pat and Rookie caught us.
I guess Frank and Alice fight sometimes even though they're the same team.
Of course! Close friends fight sometimes.
True. I fight with Krong every day too. Fight, make up, fight, make up. All right. This is a secret, but Loopy and Petty fought yesterday.
Loopy and Petty? I can't picture that.
I'll tell you, but you can't tell anyone.
Of course.
When Loopy and Petty saw us, they didn't understand why Krong and I fought every day, since they thought it would be fun to live together. But they fought as soon as they spent the night together.
Loopy and Petty were together? So why did they fight?
Wait, I'll tell you. There was a hole in Petty's roof, so water dripped into the house. Even the bed ended up wet. It takes at least a day to fix the roof, so Petty decided to spend the night at Loopy's. At first, they played dolls together, had fun, and in the end...
Oh, in the end, something big happened?
Actually, they fought for nothing. Loopy was unhappy that Petty left her bag wherever, and Petty thought Loopy wouldn't let her cook because she didn't trust her. So little by little, complaints piled up and it eventually exploded.
Yeah, I always fight with Rogi over nothing.
Loopy was angry because she tripped over Petty's bag, and Petty was angry because her book got wet because of the drink Loopy spilled when she tripped. They didn't make up and fought until nighttime. Petty was angry and left Loopy's house in the middle of the night. It was snowing so hard that you couldn't see in front of you that night.
Oh my goodness! Did Petty get home safely?
No, Petty came to my house.
To your house?
Yes. Petty's house was still being repaired, so she came to my house. Petty saw Krong and I making up when she came and decided to apologize to Loopy. So she headed back to Loopy's.
And what about Loopy?
Even Loopy was worried about Petty going out in the bad weather and went to look for her. Loopy stopped by Poby's house, and seeing Poby and Harry caring about each other, she regretted fighting with Petty.
So Loopy and Petty wanted to apologize to each other?
Yes. Loopy and Petty looked for each other in the snowstorm, met, and made up. Thank goodness, right? They helped each other get home safely and are better friends than ever before.
What a relief! But Bororo, don't you think you get closer to your friends after you fight? Strangely enough, after I fought with Rogi, we got closer when making up.
That's right. I also fight with Krong every day, and we're getting closer. We fight because we don't like something, but we understand each other better and get closer after making up. On that note, Tayo, I challenge you to a duel. Let's fight!
You? Yeah, I accept your challenge.
Tayo, I'm going to go. Krong is calling me.
Okay. Don't fight with Krong again and have fun.
You don't fight with Rogi also and have fun. Bye now.
Okay, bye.
Hello? This is the Brave Bororo speaking.
What? The Brave Bororo?
Ahem. I'm the bravest penguin known among my friends.
What? Did something happen?
I went to a scary cave today.
Scary cave story? Now wait! I want to go first! I was going to tell you a scary story too!
Yeah? You go first!
Bororo, do you, by chance, know the legend of the car?
The legend of the car? There's a car like that?
It's a scary car that appears at night! This car is very big, very fast, and has an unpleasant horn sound! It especially searches for scared children! And once you meet him, there's no coming back, they say!
There's no such thing! That's not even that scary!
Yeah, right? But Lonnie couldn't sleep after hearing this story and was scared all day! She even thought Big following her in the tunnel was the legendary car and ran away! Big managed to reassure Lonnie and got her out of the tunnel. I was just joking, but she was so scared. I felt bad.
It's your fault. Don't play such scary jokes.
Oh, it wasn't that scary, was it? Lonnie just has a lot of fear.
Well, it's not that scary, but still. So, did you properly apologize to Lonnie?
Of course. Lonnie got so angry that I prepared an event to make her feel better. Rogi and I asked Hana to help, and she showed us shadow animals.
Oh, that's a good idea. Lonnie must have liked it a lot.
Yes! We wanted to make happy memories at night so that Lonnie wouldn't even be afraid of the dark. And Lonnie accepted my apology.
Thank goodness!
Bororo, what's the cave story you were talking about? It's not a scary story, is it?
It's not that scary. Listen carefully.
Okay.
I was in a sledding race with my friends, but my sled got stuck on the hill and I fell over alone. So I walked down the hill and it became nighttime.
Wow, how high up were you? You must have been scared coming down the mountain alone at night.
I wasn't so scared because I'm brave.
but... The really scary thing was...
The scary thing?
It's when I went into a cave in the mountain.
A cave?
I walked into a dark and empty cave, all alone.
Alone?
I was walking step by step through the cave.
Walking and... What's that sound?
It's a monster!
You scared me! Bururo, why are you shouting?
I heard this sound in the cave.
Really? You must have been scared.
Right? I'm not the only one scared, right?
Were you scared too?
No, I wasn't scared at all.
Wow, that's amazing! Keep talking about the cave.
The cave wasn't that scary, but I kept thinking. I couldn't sleep well because I kept thinking about it.
It seems like you were scared.
Actually, yes. I was a little scared, but I hated my friends calling me a scaredy cat. I even went back to the cave with Petty to show I wasn't a scaredy cat.
With Petty?
Yes, Petty is brave. My friends kept comparing me to Petty, so I challenged Petty to a duel. And we went to the cave together. I even planned to tease Petty with Eddie before going to the cave.
What plan?
Eddie was going to be disguised as a monster. Then, when Petty was scared, I was going to save her, so I won't be teased anymore for being a scaredy cat.
Wow, that must have been fun! Did your plan work?
Well, Eddie was late, so... When Eddie came really late, it wasn't Petty. It was my friends waiting outside of the cave who ran away in fear at the sight of Eddie in disguise.
I wish I could have seen that myself.
It was no laughing matter. Besides, I was supposed to defeat the monster. But Petty ran out first and beat the monster, who was Eddie, with a kick.
What? So what happened?
Eddie almost fell off the cliff from Petty's kick. Everyone could only watch Eddie as the bridge was gradually splitting apart. Just then, this brave Bororo went to save Eddie!
Really? That's not a lie?
It's true. That's why I became the brave Bororo among my friends. When everyone was hesitating, I courageously ran to the cliff for Eddie. My friends saw me and took courage to save Eddie, although we all fell off the cliff trying to save Eddie.
Fell off the cliff? Bororo, are you okay?
I'm okay. It was fortunate that there was a lot of snow under the cliff. I'm fine. The ice bridge turned into a sled, so we slid all the way down to the village. It was a bit chaotic. Tayo, come play at my neighborhood next time. Let's go sledding together and go to the cave.
Sledding sounds good, but the cave...
Don't worry. The brave Bororo will be with you.
Hello? Bororo?
I think the phone is broken. I'll call again.
Bororo, what's going on? What's that?
Hello! Hey, Tayo. Doesn't the food look delicious?
Yes! It must have been delicious! Loopy made it, right? It looks like Loopy's house!
That's right. But actually, it tasted really bitter.
What? It looks so delicious in the picture!
Loopy had a cold and couldn't really taste that well. I was playing badminton with my friends, and Loopy accidentally knocked over a bucket and got soaked. I think she caught a cold then. After exercising, Loopy invited me over to eat, but the food tasted weird. The picture I just sent you is the food I ate then.
The picture looks like Loopy worked hard on it. She must have been very upset.
Yes, she was probably very upset. Then Poby took everyone to his house to cook. But it really didn't taste good. That's why it reminded me more of Loopy's food. Regardless of food, Loopy couldn't even play with us because she was sick. It was a big struggle.
Yep. When you're sick, you feel upset because you can't do anything.
So my friends and I went deep into the mountains to get medicinal herbs. We read in a book that there's an herb in the mountains that can heal Loopy.
Deep in the mountains? It must have been tough.
Yes, it was hard that day because it snowed a lot too. Everyone was all messed up. But we still got the herbs and brought them to Loopy. Loopy got better soon after eating the herbs we brought. But I don't know if it's because it was snowing heavily in the mountains, but everyone except Loopy caught a cold.
What? Still, it's amazing you all went together to the mountains to get medicinal herbs for your friend. I'm glad herbs can cure your illness. We have to get shots.
Ugh. Shots? Just thinking about it scares me.
Right? Cars have to get engine cleaner shots at the garage if they are sick. Oh, the needle is so big and sharp that it's always scary. It's not only when you get sick, but you also get a shot before getting sick, too.
Oh, it's like a vaccination?
Yes. When it's time for shots, the garage always becomes a battlefield. Everyone's busy running away. Once, Gani almost got into a big accident while running away because he didn't want to get a shot.
He didn't get a shot when he was sick? What if he gets sicker?
Oh, yeah. That day, I was also very worried about Gani. Gani wasn't feeling well and was emitting exhaust to Shine. And the passengers were uncomfortable because he was shivering. But he drove without getting a shot. And then eventually, he lost his strength going uphill.
Going uphill? That must have been dangerous.
Yes. Fortunately, I was able to find Gani and prevent the accident just in time. It was a very dangerous moment. When Shine told me about Gani, I was worried, so I went looking for him with Hana. Just then, Gani was falling backward on the hill. I found him and stopped him.
There could have been a big accident. There must have been passengers inside and a lot of cars behind. Phew, well done, Tayo. That's amazing.
Anyhow, in order to avoid accidents like this, we need to be sure to get our shots regularly.
Ugh, it's awful to think that I have to keep getting shots. Ugh. You must be going through a lot, Tayo. Hang in there. Tayo, be right back. I have to get Krong's colored pencils. Phew. Came back fast, right?
Krong must have left the colored pencils somewhere and couldn't find them, huh?
No, I'm supposed to do all the work instead of Krong today. And Krong can just sit still.
Why? Is Krong sick too?
No, but Krong took care of me really well when I was sick. Krong said he wanted to try steering a sled, so I let him. But he went so fast that the sled separated and I got hurt. I hit a tree and hurt my leg. It hurt so much that I couldn't move.
Oh, that must have been hard. Are you okay now?
Yeah, I'm all better thanks to Krong. Krong was sorry I was injured because of him, so he read me a storybook, cooked me delicious food, and pulled me on a sled. He really did everything he could.
Well, Krunk definitely thinks deeply about his friends.
Yeah, but it was so nice that Krunk did everything for me. So even though I got better, I kept asking Krunk to do this and that. I even acted like my legs were in real pain.
What?
Eventually, I got caught. But Krunk forgave me since I saved him from danger. And now, I'm serving Krunk.
Those issues actually existed.
Krunk, Krunk!
Tayo, I need to go cook because Krunk said he's hungry. I'll call you again next time.
Okay, you must have a hard day today. Hang in there. Bye.
Okay, bye.
Hello?
Tayo, Tayo, Tayo! What time is it right now that you're yawning?
Well, I couldn't sleep last night because of Lonnie snoring.
What? Lonnie snoring is that loud?
It's probably because Lonnie slept well for the first time in a long time. She hasn't been able to sleep at night.
She can't sleep at night? Why?
Lonnie took a nap one day and slept until sunset. From that day on, Lonnie's schedule was way off. She stayed up all night watching TV because she couldn't sleep. The next day was a school day, and Lonnie was deep asleep until Rogi woke her up with a loud noise.
She must have been dozing off at school, too.
That's right. How did you know? Bororo, don't you fall asleep often while studying?
No. So how was Lonnie at school?
Of course she dozed off at school, too. Maybe she was dreaming, but the teacher asked a question and she said some random answer. The classroom became full of laughter.
Lonnie must have been embarrassed.
There was more that day. We played hide-and-seek together after class. Lonnie was it. But Lonnie wasn't even looking for us and was dozing off instead. I didn't know that, so Rogi and I thought Lonnie couldn't find us. And we were hiding until nighttime.
Until night? You must have struggled while hiding. If Lonnie fell asleep while playing hide-and-seek, she must have been really tired. It reminds me of when Krunk fell asleep while hiding.
Oh yeah, Krunk fell asleep while playing hide and seek before too. It was so cute when he was sliding down the slide. Anyway, Lonnie couldn't sleep that night either and stayed up all night. And the next day she kept making mistakes at work. She was tired during the day, so she took a nap and couldn't sleep at night. She even counted sheep and played lullabies to help her fall asleep, but it was no use.
Oh, it would be dangerous to doze off while driving. There could be an accident.
That's right. That's why Hana and the rest of us set up a mission to put Lonnie to sleep.
Operation Put Lonnie to Sleep? How?
If she takes a nap, she can't sleep at night. So she can't take a nap. First of all, Hana kept Lonnie working. After Hana made her work, Rogi, Gani, and I took Lonnie to the playground and played until really late at night.
Is that the mission to put Lonnie to sleep? It seems like you just had a lot of fun.
What are you talking about? We had no choice for Lonnie's sake. It was hard to be forced to play.
So was the mission successful?
Yep. She snored and snored and slept well. That's why I was tired when I answered the phone earlier.
I see. Krunk also couldn't sleep for a few days because of nightmares.
Oh, nightmares?
Yeah. He had a nightmare of the two of us fishing, and Krunk caught a big fish.
Oh, a big fish? Isn't that a good dream?
That big fish was a shark.
A shark? Oh, that must have been really scary.
Yeah, the shark kept chasing Krunk, And that's not all. He's been dreaming of sharks ever since. One, he was riding in a hot air balloon that was losing air and falling, and there was a shark. Then he was washing his face and the water wouldn't turn off, so the house filled up with water and there was a shark again.
Did Krong hear a scary shark story? It's all sharks!
Possibly? Anyhow, I went to Tong Tong to get a magic pill to stop Krong from having nightmares, but it didn't work. And Eddie made a helmet that blocks nightmares, but it didn't work either. Rather, Krong dreamt that we left him with a scary gorilla and ran away.
From sharks to gorillas? Krong must have been really scared.
The last method we came up with so that Krong wouldn't have nightmares was to sleep all together with him. Poby came up with that idea.
All together? Ooh!
Yes, we all worked together to help Krong have a good dream. Petty brought Krong some warm milk. Loopy lent him a doll. And Harry was going to sing. But he didn't sing because it might actually wake him up instead. Krong fell asleep when Poby read him a storybook.
You all came together for Krong! You are really good friends! So what dream did Krong have?
Krong said that his friends saved him from being in a gorilla prison this time. I think they pretended to give the gorilla delicious food, but gave the shark instead. The scary shark started chasing the gorilla and not Krong. Isn't that great?
Yes! Thank goodness! Oh my gosh, I'm still sleepy, Pororo. I need to sleep more. I'll get in trouble if I drive drowsy.
Okay, but only sleep a bit, or you won't be able to sleep at night like Lonnie and be in big trouble. Should I call and wake you up in an hour?
I'd appreciate that. Thank you, Pororo. Then I'll depend on you and sleep a little more.
Okay, I'll call back later. Good night.
Okay, bye. Hello?
Tayo, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, too! So, what's up?
Well, I've had a hard time decorating that tree, so I'm calling to tell you about it. Actually, Eddie knocked it down, and we had to start all over.
Oh, really? How did Eddie knock it down?
You have to do nice things to get presents from Santa Claus, right?
Right! Santa Claus only gives gifts to children who are nice!
Yes, Harry, Loopy, Petty, Poby, Krong, and I all thought we could get gifts from Santa for doing nice things. But Eddie couldn't think of anything good he did.
No way!
Huh? Can you take a guess?
Maybe. Did he start doing good things late?
Huh? How did you know?
Actually, I was like that too. I couldn't think of one single good deed that I did other than working hard every day.
What?
So, I did a bunch of good things even if it was late. I helped with construction work, delivered goods, and even cleaned the playground.
Oh, you did a good job.
Actually, I only caused problems for everyone.
What? Like Eddie knocking down our Christmas tree?
Yep.
Eddie suddenly tried to do something nice also, but only made a lot of mistakes. He tried to bring some salt to Loopy but failed, and failed to try and help us decorate the Christmas tree. He tried to help Harry, but just ended up waking him up.
Oh man, I understand that feeling.
Nighttime came, but Eddie hadn't done anything good. When Santa Claus came to our town, Eddie saw him.
Huh? Eddie saw Santa Claus? Oh, I saw Santa Claus too!
Really? I'm jealous. I only heard about it from Eddie. Anyhow, Santa's sleigh broke down, so Eddie fixed it and handed out gifts to our town instead.
Oh, Eddie was Santa for a day!
Yes, Santa Claus insisted that the gifts be delivered secretly, so he had a hard time giving the gifts without us knowing. Even though Eddie didn't have a gift in the bag, he worked hard to deliver the ones for his friends to be happy.
Eddie's so nice!
Yes, Eddie's such a nice friend. Eddie handed out all the presents, and when he arrived home, there was a gift for Eddie left by Santa Claus himself.
Wow, how awesome! A nice friend like Eddie would definitely get a gift from Santa Claus! I also help Santa Claus give presents to everyone!
You too?
Yeah! Actually, at first, I didn't recognize Santa Claus and I thought he was a burglar!
What? Oh, goodness!
You know, if you saw Santa in disguise, you'd think he was a burglar too! Let's see, I took a picture then because I thought it was a burglar!
Well, you really can't recognize him in disguise.
Right? Plus, Santa Claus ran away from me at first, so I really thought he was a burglar. Eventually, Santa called Rudolph to clear up the misunderstanding. Afterward, I helped Santa find the present he lost.
You even helped him find the lost gift.
Yes, and Santa Claus lost his sleigh. So I helped him move the presents instead of the sleigh.
Santa sure does lose a lot of things. Anyhow, that's great, Tayo.
While I helped Santa Claus, I even gave my gift to a friend. Santa couldn't find all the presents that he had lost, so I gave up mine because I didn't want my friend to be upset.
Wow, you did a lot of nice things in a short amount of time. Maybe you'll get double the presents next year.
Maybe so.
Tayo, it's snowing outside. Krong asked me to go look at the snow with him, so I'll get off now. Again, Merry Christmas, Tayo!
Huh? It really is snowing! Merry Christmas to you too, Pororo!
Hello?
Pororo! I was startled because I thought it was your birthday today. I didn't even get a present.
It was Krong's birthday. What would you have gotten me if it was my birthday?
That's a secret.
How about a wish-granting bell?
A bell that grants wishes? What's that?
I gave it to Krong for his birthday this time. It's really hard to choose a gift. I don't really know what to give. Especially on Krong's birthday this year, I was more worried because other friends said they were giving what I was going to give.
What kind of presents did the other friends give?
I was going to give a toy robot, but Eddie and Rhodey said they were giving a remote control robot. And when I was going to get a birthday cake, Loopy and Petty said they were getting it. Then, when I thought I should draw a picture that Krong likes...
Did Pooby and Harry say they were already going to draw a picture?
Yes! Even if I just thought about a gift, my friends said they were already getting it. So the gift that I came up with was a wish-granting bell. Krong was reading a magic lamp book and said he wanted a magic lamp too. That's where I got the idea.
Oh, that's a good idea! How many wishes did it grant?
Oh, that's right! I should have chosen the number of wishes. I didn't think about that and granted all of Krong's wishes.
Really? Well, Bororo, please give me a wish-granting bell on my birthday, too.
What? No way! I almost fought with Krong because of that.
Really?
Yeah, Krong would ring the bell all the time. So I was it instead of him during hide-and-seek and acted like I didn't notice even when I found him. I even said I farted when it was really him. I was so embarrassed.
I can't believe you said that you farted instead.
I really regretted giving Krong that bell for that reason. Lastly, he didn't help me clean the house, but he made even more mess, so I left the house.
Krong was a little overboard. What about now? Did you make up?
Yep, Krong even cleaned the house, and his last wish was for me to play with him. Me being kind, I forgave him.
I'm glad Krong's birthday ended well. We also had a surprise birthday party for Hannah at the bus garage a few days ago. I'll show you how cool it was.
Wow, so cool.
Right? Aside from this stage, all the cars joined forces to prepare a variety of events. All the cars had microphones and participated in the big celebration of Hannah's birthday. First, Nuri took Hannah out to town in the morning. While they were in town, we started setting up the stage.
Very interesting. What next?
This was Rogi's plan. A hamburger and pizza tasting event on the street for when Hannah is hungry. Hannah really enjoyed eating it.
Hamburger and pizza? That must have been yummy.
And Hannah said she needed engine oil and cleaning fluid. So Shine gave them to her as gifts when he pretended to pass by. This was planned by Gani. And the biggest event? We made Hannah the 1,000,000th person to cross the bridge!
The 1,000,000th person to cross the bridge? What kind of event is that?
Well, there's a bridge over the river, and they give dresses and take pictures of the 1,000,000th person who crosses it. I did this event. I don't know how many times Bong Bong and I crossed the bridge so that Hannah could be the 1,000,000th person. It was so difficult, but I just thought about how it would make Hannah happy and worked hard.
Whoa, Tayo, that's amazing. So did Hannah become the 1,000,000th person?
Yes, of course! I succeeded! It was my plan!
Hannah must have been really happy!
Yes! Lastly, we celebrated Hannah's birthday together by showing her a birthday performance! Hannah didn't even know it was her birthday, but she was so happy because of us! Tears of emotion!
Tayo, I'm looking forward to my birthday after hearing your story!
Of course you're looking forward to it! What? Your birthday?
My birthday is coming soon!
Okay, your birthday.
What I want for my birthday is...
Hannah? I have to work right now? This minute?
Tayo, I don't hear Hannah's voice, though.
Yes, I'll be right there. Bororo, Hannah's calling me, so I'm going to go. Okay, bye.
Tayo! Tayo, that's messed up. Hello?
Bororo, what's with the picture?
It's a picture of the moon. I've been to space firsthand.
The moon? You've been to space too?
Too? Tayo, did you really go to space?
Well, I told Hana that I wanted to go to space, and she made me a flying space rocket. I went on a trip to space with the rockets.
Wow, Hana can do everything.
That's right. Hana is an all-around mechanic. I was so excited when I went to space. Did you see the picture I sent earlier? I even followed that shooting star in the picture.
Wow, following a shooting star? Tayo, that's amazing.
Yeah, it was really great. Oh, and while in space, I met Princess Rei, who looked just like Hana.
Princess Rei?
Yes, Princess Rei is the princess of the Clover Star. She was being chased by the space pirate Bully. I helped the princess defeat Bully. I hit a meteor and got a scar too. Do you know how tense it was?
What? Clover Star? Space pirate? Something is a bit fishy.
I've been to Clover Star. There are so many clovers there, and it's so beautiful. It's such a shame that only I saw it. If you saw it, you'd really like it too.
Tayo, this is a place I can go, right?
Oh?
Remember what I said earlier? That I went to the moon with Eddie.
Fish, how can you go to the moon?
That's right. Space travel is not an easy task, so how can I go? I lied about going to the moon with Eddie, so I know how you feel.
Of course you do, Pororo. You caught me right away. So, Eddie was lying about going to the moon?
You know Eddie is making a rocket because he wants to go to space, right?
Yes, Eddie's inventions are amazing. Is he making a rocket too?
He is building a rocket, but he's failed several times. So his friends didn't expect much from Eddie's space trip. Everyone thought, he's probably going to fail again. Eddie also noticed that his friends didn't expect much. So, this time, he tried really hard to succeed.
Oh, no way! Did he fail again? And is that why he lied?
Yup. I knew how upset Eddie was after trying so hard, so I suggested we act as if we went to the moon. We even made a backdrop of the moon. Want to see?
Yeah!
What do you think?
Looking at it again, it's sloppy.
Did we make it too hastily? Even my friends were a little suspicious. They didn't think it looked like the moon. I almost got caught because the backdrop of the moon was blowing in the wind. So I distracted my friends and quickly turned off the screen. My heart was beating so fast.
You fooled your friends with that picture? You must have been really nervous.
To distract my friends a little more, I even showed up dressed as an alien.
Dressed as an alien?
Yeah. I drew an alien on a box and imitated how an alien would sound.
What are alien sounds?
It's, you want to hear it?
Yeah. What is that?
It's because I'm a little embarrassed right now, but when I did it in front of my friends, it was really like an alien.
What did you do next?
I couldn't think of anything after that. So I asked Eddie to come back home. All my friends welcomed Eddie back from the moon.
You did a great job, Pororo. Eddie must have been very thankful to you.
Of course. There's no friend like me.
Next time, I want to go on Pororo's trip to the moon, too.
Okay. I hid the backdrop of the moon under the sofa. I wonder if it's okay. I'll go take a look. Hold on a second, Tayo.
Okay.
Krong, how did you find that?
Krong, Krong.
It's just like the moon that Eddie went to?
It's, Tayo, I think Krong just caught me. I'll call you back later, okay?
Krong, Krong!
Okay, call me back later. Bye!
Okay, bye!
Hello?
Hi, Pororo. How have you been?
Tayo, your voice sounds weak. Did something happen?
Well, today, Rogi, Lonnie, and I switched work routes. I picked up passengers on Lonnie's route, and Rogi did my route, and Lonnie did Rogi's route. Oh, it was so hectic.
Huh? What are you talking about? I'm confused. Tell me in more detail.
Phew. Well, when I said that today's work was harder than usual, Rogi said that his work was much harder than mine. So I was arguing with Rogi about who had it harder when Lonnie came in and said hers was the hardest.
Phew, it must have been hard for everyone. Guess you argued about something useless.
Now that I think about it, that's true. Anyhow, Gani saw us arguing and suggested that we switch our driving routes and see. That's why we all switched our driving routes.
Ah, that's what you meant. So you did Lonnie's route?
Yes, I did Lonnie's route. Rogi did mine. And Lonnie did Rogi's. Everyone brushed it off by saying how easy it would be compared to the route they normally work and left.
Really? So how was Lonnie's route?
It was very different from what I thought. I was surprised at how different passengers' tastes were on each course. I have a lot of little kid passengers on my route, and when I fart, everyone laughs and likes it. But the passengers on Lonnie's route said it was rude and really didn't like it.
Oh no, really? Farting is your specialty. That's too bad.
Yeah, what's so rude about it?
How can someone not recognize how well you fart?
Right? Anyhow, that's not all. They didn't like my singing. Oh yeah, there was a passenger who was angry that I didn't wake her up at the department store bus stop, even though she didn't push the bell to get off. I didn't even do anything wrong. I was so upset. Lonnie must have had a really hard time.
It's definitely very different to experience something firsthand versus watching from the sideline. So now you realize how hard your friends work?
Yes, not only me, but Rogi and Lonnie also realized how hard each other's routes were. The route I work has a lot of children, so you have to fart and sing well. And the route that Rogi works requires a lot of driving skills because the passengers like to go fast. And Lonnie's route has a lot of sensitive passengers, so kindness is the most important thing.
So everyone was working where they were needed.
Yeah, because we're all good at different things. Anyhow, I had a hard time with the work changes today. Pororo, did anything happen with you today?
Me? I went snowboarding in the blizzard today. I even took a picture at the top. Want to see?
Is that the top of the mountain? I can't tell.
What? That's the top.
Snowboarding through a blizzard? Oh, wasn't that dangerous?
It was fairly doable at first, but it started snowing more forcefully, so I went down halfway.
Well, guess nothing much happened. I'm so tired.
I didn't do much, but Krong, Eddie, and Rhodey had a tough day.
Why? What happened?
They thought I was snowboarding in the blizzard and went looking for me in the mountains. But I was at Poby's house building blocks with Poby, Harry, and Petty.
You guys missed each other!
Yeah, and it snowed so much. All right, Dudu was there too. He even chained his tires in case it was slippery and went from place to place in the mountains to look for me. Rhodey ran around here and there telling everyone that he thought I was trapped in the mountains. Dudu, Krong, and Eddie almost got run over by a snowball while looking for me.
What? Oh, seems they had a harder day than mine.
Yeah, they got stuck on a dead-end cliff trying to avoid the snowball. I didn't know anything and even went to Loopy's house to have a sandwich when the weather got better.
Stuck on a cliff? So what happened?
I found out when Rhodey came to spread the news, and I rushed to the mountains. Finding Krong, Eddie, and Dudu on the cliff, Rhodey connected the cliff to the mountain with his long arm and safely rescued them. If Rhodey hadn't come to spread the news, it could have been a disaster.
Oh, jeez. Thank goodness they were rescued safely.
Yes, the weather was so bad. But luckily, everyone was safe with no injuries while in the mountains. Mm-hmm.
Right. Bororo, I should go to bed now. Maybe it's because I worked Lonnie's route today, but I'm getting sleepy earlier than normal.
You're going to sleep already? Okay, Tayo. You did a great job today. Let's talk again next time.
Okay, I'll call again next time. Bye!
Bye!
Hello!
Hi, Tayo! Isn't the picture cool? This is a picture of the picnic I went on today.
A picnic? Sounds like a lot of fun! I like going on picnics, too!
Really? Then let's go on a picnic together next time!
Great! When should we go?
Anytime is fine. Tomorrow? The day after tomorrow?
Tomorrow? I have to work tomorrow. And the day after tomorrow is also a work day.
You're so busy, Tayo. I don't work every day.
Wow, I envy that the most. I wish I didn't work every day. Do you know what I did the last time I wanted to go on a picnic? I was so jealous of Rhodey when he said he was going on a picnic on his day off. I was feeling sad that I couldn't go when suddenly Speed and Toto said they were going on a picnic too. I've been wanting to go on a picnic ever since. The real decisive moment was the night Rhodey told me about his picnic. After I heard Rhodey bragging, I decided to go on a picnic the next day.
The next day was your day off? Thank goodness.
No. Of course I had to work.
Huh? Then how could you go on a picnic?
I really wanted to go on a picnic. I lied about being sick.
What? You pretended to be sick?
I lied that I couldn't work because I felt strange. I fooled everyone. But Gani, who was supposed to be off that day, said he'd gladly work instead of me. I kind of felt bad.
As expected, Gani's a really good friend. So, how was the secret picnic, huh?
At first, it was really exciting. I felt my mind clearing from the cool breeze. But I ran into a broken-down car on the way. Toto said we couldn't just pass the broken-down car. So I went to the garage instead of going on a picnic.
You gave up your picnic? Toto is very responsible, isn't he? It's amazing that you gave up playing. So, what happened to the picnic?
Of course, I gave up on the picnic and went back to work. I'm also a responsible bus. And I felt bad that Gani was working for me. I quickly went back and finished working the bus service.
Wow, Tayo, you're quite responsible. I'm seeing you in a new light.
Pororo, now tell me about your picnic. I want to hear it.
Yep, this picnic was very special.
Why? How was it?
I went to the butterfly forest.
The butterfly forest?
It's a secret between me and Krong. I'll only tell you.
Okay.
My friends and I went on a picnic in the forest, and Krong and I left our luggage on the train, so we went to get it. We got our things and were going back to the forest when the snow disappeared and a different forest appeared.
What? Pororo, this wasn't a dream?
I've really been there. If you don't believe me, I'll just not tell you.
No! Tell me!
Well, you might not believe it, because it wasn't a picnic that just anyone could go on. Anyhow, Krong and I helped a butterfly caught in a spider's web. The butterfly invited us to the butterfly forest. We went under a wooden column to avoid the rain. And there was a connecting passage. When we went all the way down the passageway, there was a beautiful butterfly forest.
Whoa! It's under a wooden column. Should I look for it?
Not just anyone can find it. We saved a butterfly, played together, and became friends. We looked around the forest with the butterfly friends, ran around on flowers, and played hide and seek. It was so much fun, but...
But?
I thought I knew where the butterfly friend was hiding, so I went behind the mushrooms, but there was a spider hiding.
The spider in the web that you saved the butterfly from earlier?
Yes, the spider came after us, and it was really scary. I really thought we were going to get caught. Just then, the butterfly friends saved us. Just like we saved our butterfly friends.
That's a relief. Pororo, do you have any pictures you took in the butterfly forest? I'm curious.
Well, I forgot to take a picture because I was so busy playing.
Oh, what a shame. Oh, well. Pororo, let's go on a picnic together in the countryside next time. My friend Nana lives in the countryside. There are lots of delicious apples and cute little baby pigs.
Baby pigs? Okay, going on a picnic in the countryside would be really fun.
Yes, I have to get ready for work now, so I'm going to get off.
Okay, you're so responsible, Tayo. Well done, I'm going to play more.
What? Fine, go! Hello? Hi, Pororo!
Hi, Tayo! Where do you think I took this picture with Eddie? Where does it look like?
It's like a hill or something. Where is it? I'm not sure. Did you go up the mountain?
It looks like I went up somewhere high and took the picture, right? Actually, I took it on top of Krong's nose.
What? Krong's nose? No way! Don't tell me that thing that looks like a cave is a nostril?
It is! Krong got so big!
Really? What happened?
Krong always said he wanted to grow taller. Like the book Eddie told him about, he drank milk every day, exercised, and slept and woke up early in order to grow taller.
Is that really how he got taller?
That's not it. Krong and I arrived at Tong Tong's house while running to grow taller. Tongtong heard about us and put a spell on Krong to grow taller.
Oh, Tongtong's magic made him taller. I thought he got bigger after touching a machine like I did.
Machine? What do you mean you got bigger?
Hana invented a machine that can make big things smaller so it's easy to move. I was so amazed that I was examining it here and there and...
So things didn't get bigger, but you did.
No, I got smaller. The opposite of Krong. Hana told me not to touch it because it's dangerous. But I became as small as a toy car and was actually mistaken for a toy.
You were mistaken for a toy car? What do you mean?
Pat's niece, Jeannie, came to visit the garage and was playing with a toy car and left me instead of the toy car. Oh, Hana couldn't even hear my voice because I was so small. I was so scared that I'd have to live as a toy car forever.
Oh, no one could hear you. That must have been really scary. Krong was so worried that he wouldn't be able to go back to his normal size, too.
Why? Isn't getting taller good?
Yeah, he got so much bigger than us, as you can see in the picture. I could have jumped and played on Krong's nose. I thought his nostril was a cave. He couldn't live a normal life with us.
It's a problem to get smaller, but I guess it's also a problem to get bigger.
Yes, the spell that Tongtong put on Krong was slightly wrong, and he got so big. Tongtong came back to our town and released the growth spell, and Krong returned to normal. Of course, Tongtong couldn't fix it in one go. I think he has been making a lot of mistakes lately. Krong grew so tall that he even pierced through space.
What? To outer space?
Yeah, I was actually a little envious of Krong being big enough to see space. But how did you go back to normal from being small?
It's a long story. I really didn't think I'd go back to normal. Jeannie thought I was a toy car. So she kept shaking me, bumping me into the wall. It seems she couldn't hear me. I knew I'd have to get back to the garage from Jeannie's house to solve this problem. So I launched an escape mission.
Escape mission?
Yeah, but my body was so small that I only managed to open the door. A day passed by just opening the door. As soon as I opened the door, Jeannie caught me!
You spent all day opening the door and got caught by Jeannie right away?
Yeah, it was so futile! Very luckily, Hana noticed that I was missing and came to Jeannie's house to find me! She traded me for the toy car. I don't know how lucky I was!
Hana to the rescue! I'm glad you're back safe.
Yes! I'm not going to get close to any new machines from now on. Just thinking about that time, it was awful.
Yeah? But I think it would be fun to be big like a giant or small as an ant at least once.
What are you talking about? You'll regret it right away.
Still.
Oh, do you want to come to our garage right now? I'll tell Hana about it, and you can experience being small right now!
What? Now? Right now?
Yeah! Hana!
No, wait! I have to clean my room now, so I'm hanging up! Krong always makes a mess! well then, bye!
Come after cleaning up!
I'm busy! Bye!
Bororo's chicken!
Whatever! Bye!
Hello?
Hi, Tayo. You sound so weak. What's the matter?
Phew. I was busy taking care of baby cars today. Oh.
baby cars? You didn't work today.
Today was my day off. And Kiri asked me to take care of the baby cars for a bit. So I played with the baby cars. And four of them at that.
Ugh, it's so hard to take care of just Krong, but four? You must have had a really hard time, too. What did you play?
First, we practiced driving in the garage. Then we went to the playground and played tag. The little cars wanted to play tag in the garage. But there were a lot of dangerous things in there, so I took them to the playground.
Oh, Tayo, that's wise.
But playgrounds are dangerous for baby cars, too. I didn't know I'd keep saying things like, "No, don't do that! That's dangerous! It's dangerous to play like that! Don't do that! Everyone, stop it!"
Ugh, Tayo, did you nag at the playground? You like to nag as much as Loopy, don't you?
What? I like to nag? That's ridiculous! It's because you don't know the situation!
What do I not know? The story reminds me exactly of Loopy! A few days ago, I went to Loopy's house and accidentally spilled the milk that she was carrying. That's when Loopy's strange nagging started. She said she'd tell me before anything dangerous happened and said no to this and no to that, no to everything. It was so tiring.
I'm sure Loopy had her reasons too.
Of course, naggers understand each other.
No! I don't like nagging either!
Loopy is a little worse than you are. She wouldn't let me run on the playground. Told me to swing gently. And even told Eddie to make his invention with a toy hammer.
What? How can you make an invention with a toy hammer?
Right? She told me not to do anything that might be even a little bit dangerous. Eventually, my friends and I were wondering if there was a way to stop Loopy's nagging and even planned to do things she likes to make her forget her nagging. So I went on a picnic with her, which she likes.
Did you not go on a picnic because it was dangerous?
Yeah, we thought so too. I thought Loopy would say that a picnic was dangerous, so I managed to take her by decorating her train seat really pretty. She nagged that it's dangerous to go fast while on the train! Ugh!
But trains are supposed to go fast!
I know, right? Anyhow, we finally arrived on the hill, and Loopy asked to go down again. She said it looked like it was going to snow when she saw the clouds. Poppy told Loopy that she was too worried, and Rhodey teased her that she nagged too much. Loopy got mad and went down the hill alone.
So what happened? Did you make up?
Yeah. Well, it really did snow after Loopy went down. It snowed so much that we were trapped in a cave. Everyone regretted not listening to what Loopy said. I was worried about Loopy leaving first while I was in the cave. And I understood why she nagged us. She says things because she's worried about her friends.
That's right! Worries and nags happen because someone cares. Actually, I took care of the baby cars because I wanted Hannah to stop nagging me and to show her that I was mature. But when I took care of the baby cars, I understood Hannah's feelings.
You didn't want to hear Hannah's nagging anymore?
Huh? Hannah nags as much as Loopy. Drive safely, get up early even on your day off, wash when you wake up. This is all the stuff I do on my own without Hannah telling me, but she kept nagging me so I got a little annoyed. I was upset that she didn't trust me. So I was going to take care of the baby cars to proudly show Hannah my mature side.
But you came to understand Hannah while taking care of the baby cars, right?
That's right. I didn't want to nag the baby cars either. Oh, but I kept nagging them so they wouldn't get hurt. Oh, what's worse, Bong Bong said...
Why can't I play? I know what I'm doing. This is no fun.
I was surprised because it was so similar to what I said to Hana before. Hana was also worried about me, but I thought she was nagging. I was so sorry.
That's right. Loopy's nagging was all because she was worried about us. They don't nag because they don't trust us and hate us, but because they care about us.
Yes, that's right. After I took care of the baby cars and came back to the garage, I apologized to Hana. I apologize for grumbling every time she nagged me. It's all because she's worried about me.
Still, I wish Loopy would nag a little less.
Yes, if only Hana would reduce her nagging a little bit too.
Oh, it's so late already. I have to go have sandwiches at Loopy's, so I'm going to go.
Okay. Be careful not to hear any nagging today.
I'm sure I'll still hear nagging even if I am careful.
I know. When I see Hana nagging constantly.
Okay then. Bye.
Bye.
Hello!
How have you been, Bororo?
Good. It's been a while since we talked. Have you been busy lately?
Yes. I've been a little busy lately preparing for the Bus Day Festival. Did you see the picture?
Yes, a festival. It must have been so much fun. If it's a festival, I can't miss it. Playing is my favorite thing.
Unfortunately, only cars can participate in the Bus Day Festival.
Aw, too bad. Can't I go with Tutu? What did you do at the festival? Tell me all about it.
Okay. At the Bus Day Festival, cars show off their talents. And at the end, there's also an award ceremony for Best Bus of the Year.
Wow, that must have been fun showing off your talents. I don't think I've ever seen a car talent show anywhere. Too bad I haven't seen one. Did you participate?
Well, I've been busy preparing for the talent show lately. But unfortunately, I couldn't participate.
Huh? You prepared for it, but you couldn't participate?
Yeah. I excitedly prepared my specialty of farting to match the rhythm. But something came up and I couldn't participate. I even signed up for it and worked really hard on it.
You must have been upset. What came up?
I wasn't that upset. On my way to the festival, I had to help some people who needed help, so I was late. I took a little kid who was left alone on the street back to the kindergarten. And I took a pregnant lady who was about to have her baby to the hospital.
Whoa, Tayo, you're amazing! You must have wanted to go to the festival, but you still helped people. That's really awesome.
Actually, something even cooler happened.
What? Something even cooler happened?
Did you see the last picture? At the end of the festival, only one gets picked for the best bus of the year. And I won the award!
Wow! You're the best bus of the year?
Yes! Wait, I'll send you a picture. It's an award given to the bus that did the best job during the year. And I won the award!
What's this? It's not that different from the picture you sent earlier.
Look closer. The angles are slightly different.
All right. You gave up the talent show and put off the festival to help people. Tayo, you deserve it. Congratulations.
You think so too? Thank you, Pororo. What have you been up to?
Me? I made a Borong Borong Super Team picture book with Krong and my friends yesterday.
Wow! You made a picture book? I'm looking forward to the Borong Borong Super Team! What's it about?
One sec!
Oh! Are you and Krong the main characters?
No, at first, I only drew me and Krong. But right then, my friends came over to play, so all of them made an appearance in the book. Krong, Pobi, Eddie, Petty, and I make up the Borong Borong Super Team, and Loopy, Harry, and Rhodey are all in there. We're all the main characters.
Oh, the Borong Borong Super Team sounds fun!
It was about to be boring at first, but it got more and more fun because everyone came up with the story together.
Really? Hurry and tell me the story!
First, I, Super Bororo, have the ability to fly in the sky, and Super Krong has the ability to run very fast. Super Pobi is so strong that he can lift anything, and Super Eddie can create anything. Lastly, Super Petty has the ability to hear even distant sounds.
Everyone has superpowers? Oh, you made it up well!
Right? The setup was fun. But I couldn't think of a story to start with at first. I could only think of cleaning up Loopy's house and listening to Harry singing alone.
Wouldn't it be fun for the super team to gather and clean?
What? But it's a waste for the super team with so many abilities to just clean up and listen to music. So, Rhodey suggested that he appear as a villain.
That's right! Only when there's a villain, there's a job for the hero. But how can sweet Rhodey play the villain?
At first, Rhodey was not a scary villain. But he made himself to be so much bigger than us and added the storyline to kidnap the princess in the town. The princess is Loopy.
Oh, the story's getting more and more interesting.
Oh, yeah? Petty, who has super hearing, heard Loopy's voice asking for help. And when the villain Rhodey kidnapped Princess Loopy, Krong ran over quickly and caught Rhodey's attention. Powerful Pobi blocked the villain's foot when he tried to step on us, and right then, I flew Princess Loopy to safety.
Oh, you're a perfect team! But what about Eddie?
Yeah, Rhodey's friend Harry shows up and says that Rhodey is usually a good friend, but he's like that now because he's broken. That's when Super Eddie fixes Rhodey. We're the nice Borong Borong Super Team. So we made friends with the villain Rhodey as well.
Oh, I've never heard of making friends with a villain. The story's really well made. I want to see the book too.
Really? Then I'll bring the book and lend it to you today.
Good, good. Let's read it to Rogi, Lonnie, and Gani too.
Yes, it's too bad that this book is the only one of it in the world, so I can't give it to you. Ma, should I make another copy and bring it?
Yeah, that's even better.
Then I'll make it really quick and bring it. So let's hang up, Tayo.
Okay, I'm looking forward to it, Bororo.
Okay, bye now.
Okay, see you later.